Welcome to episode 60 of The 6-Inch Show. We love Hasbro, Marvel Legends, Star Wars, The Black Series, G.I. Joe Classified, and just about anything 6-Inch in that kind of line. Mafex and other stuff, SH Figure Arts. I'm Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net, joined as always by my good buddy, probably on that side, Mr. Matt. I know. This way. It's like air traffic controllers here. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm good. A little bit cold, but good.
You're all pre-primed, and if you notice, we haven't really talked about Matt's kind of little displays in his background for a while, but we should have. But anyway, tonight's is pretty apt because it's all the figures we're going to talk about, because by the time you're watching the show and we're pre-recording it, there's a whole bunch of Marvel stuff which is going to come out. So this is scheduled to go live just as Marvel do their announcement, allowing you to go out and buy these products straight away. So we'll put links in the show notes. Well, in fact, there is no real show notes. We'll put some links underneath the description on YouTube underneath. In the meantime, we're going to show you these reveals. So there's a bunch of stuff that's going to be revealed. Now, we think, both of us, that this is pretty much all of it. So we're doing it before the live Facebook Q&A session, because we had the Star Wars one, God, I feel like weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks?
3 weeks ago. I think they've done, they've done Power Rangers since then. They did something else. They did, I don't know.
My Little Pony or something. I don't know.
2 weeks or 3 weeks.
So we've got a Marvel Legends Facebook Q&A session with Steve Evans, could be there, potentially, hopefully, and others, Dwight and the guys from that team. But they've got some stuff to reveal, some of which we've seen. We've got some product glams we're going to go through and show you them and just discuss, the two of us, just what we like and what we don't. But before we get into the Marvel Legends, there was some new images. Let me just share on screen here. There was some new images of Star Wars The Black Series, which were shared, and hopefully you can see that on screen. Yep. So we got some new glams, basically, of four of the figures that are in one of the upcoming Star Wars waves. I loved that. I thought it was such a good job of Gregory Titus to capture that picture of Anakin there. Love it. Really, really good. Anakin Skywalker, Padawan. I think it looks really good. A couple of people were griping on Twitter that they didn't like it and they thought it wasn't very good. But I thought that was pretty sharp, to be honest.
I think it's pretty good, given, as you know, that I watched Attack of the Clones for some reason 2 days ago. Both Gregory Titus has nailed it. And that is a good look of Anakin. Like, I mean, I think people forget how different Attack of the Clones Anakin did look to Revenge of the Sith Anakin, and everyone just thinks of Revenge of the Sith Anakin, but there was this awkward film of awkward hair, and I think it's good.
Somebody mentioned it as well today on Twitter. This isn't apparently his right lightsaber. I'm not a lightsaber aficionado, but yeah, they were saying it's one of Grievous's lightsabers and it's not accurate. So there you go.
I wouldn't know. I remember he had two lightsabers, because he loses one chasing Sam Weasel. And then he gets another blue one, which he then loses again. It gets cut in half on Geonosis. And then he gets the green one after that. So
there you go. It's looking pretty good, I thought. There's a box art for Kit Fisto, looking very nice yet again in the Gregory Titus artwork. Very nicely done. And again, apparently the lightsaber isn't apparently quite right, but well, who knows? Not me, not that I care, because I think that looks fantastic for a calamari squid dude, kind of, really. He looks pretty incredible, actually, I think.
I think he looks good.
Yeah, he does. I mean, considering what he could look like, we've seen some figures before where they just, you know, they just don't turn out right, but that looks pretty damn good. So same kind of Jedi body and stuff, and he's got his little flicks in his fingers. Wasn't there supposed to be a spearhead smiling kit? No, I can't remember.
Was there?
Wasn't there?
No, I wasn't aware of it.
I always thought there was something about
such a massive head.
True. I thought there was some kind of, like, you know, like the, I guess, like the Rebel Trooper, some swapper or something they mentioned. Yes, Kit Fisto will have his iconic smile. And I'm like, yeah, he's not really smiling there. But there we go. I'm sure we'll get a re-release or some kind at some point. So, but yeah, looking pretty good on the box art. And the other one, which I thought was really good, Dave Filoni's favourite, Plo Koon. Look at the detail on that mask, man. Absolutely superb. Looking very good. And even again, the rendition of that, I think with the paint, the weathering, a little bit of gold, a little bit of silver here and there. Cape doesn't look as if it's up to much.
That's going to come down to that. It's always going to be a weird cape in packaging. This one will come down to how it is out of the packet because it's done in strips.
Yeah.
It's not actually it's almost like if you had a belt, you could Darth Vader it kind of
thing. Yeah.
It's not a full cloak. It's kind of strips and the sleeves are still there. It's just weirdly cut.
No idea if that's the right lightsaber, but it looks nice. Yeah, solid again. It looks pretty good. I love the Gregory Titus artwork. He's just got better and better and better over time. And another repainted battle droid, the Geonosis battle droid. Really pretty much not much different from the heavy, frankly. but same old battle droid that they've now, this is the fourth time that this has been out, I think. One, two, three?
Third.
But there'll be a fourth. There will be a fourth.
They'll start putting the yellow yeah, and the blues.
There's going to be others, that's for sure. That's it, I think, for Star Wars. So those new reveals and those figures up there on Dorsey Toys, BBTS, and all those other usual places if you want to go and buy them. But that's pretty much it for Star Wars. Tell I, there's one more. It was the new box art for the back of the Luke and Dagobah Jedi training there, just in case you really want to. It's nothing really dramatically new, but if you hadn't seen it, again, great artwork by Gregory. He's done such a good job there. D4 on the deluxe number 4 figure. So that was that. The other stuff which has been revealed is Marvel Legends. We know about the Spider-Man Retro Wave, and we've seen some of them. We'll get into them in a minute, but I thought let's kill off, tell what we'll do, my favourite. I was floored by this. I thought it was really, really good. And you and I were talking about, what could a deluxe War Machine be, thinking a movie version a couple of weeks ago. But here you go, Marvel Legends War Machine comic version. What do you think?
I don't mind it. As you know, I like the movie War Machines, and I'm not an Iron Man head like you. it is good. It looks good. It looks like the War Machine I knew from the comics in the 80s, or is it the 80s or the 90s? I can't remember. Don't know how mad I am about the Rhodey head, but yeah. The Iron Man looks good, and the silver looks good.
It does.
So the makes me want that... That silver we're talking about the other day offline about the whatever Iron Man it was, the red and silver one.
Yep.
Seeing that silver there is kind of like, I want that red Iron Man.
Yeah, I know what you mean. There's a lot of reused bits and pieces here. This is element has been used before. Was it Gambit or something? I can't remember.
Gambit had cards like that, but
not. Yeah, I don't know what they've done. We've got a little bits here from Black Widow. Yeah. We've got the two bases which were used on the recent Iron Man 2020, not 2020.
Yeah, 2020.
Was it 2020? Yeah. Iron Man 2020 base or piece. I think some of the other stuff is new. This reminds me of something somewhere. Maybe it was from Overwatch, I think this was potentially from this little piece of missiles here. New head for Rhodey, I think based off a really early War Machine comic, if memory serves, but I love the classic look of it. I'll lay money down here on the show. I bet you this War Machine ends up with a lot less accessories in a retro card some point down the future. It just kind of makes sense, doesn't it, to reuse it and put it on some of the retro cards that they've done. So that's the main pack shot, and just some other ones there just to showcase it off. Just love all the colours here, the grey, the silver, the black, the red. Just looks really, really nice. And there's a shot there. It doesn't quite work there. It just looks a little odd. Like a banana peel or something coming out there.
Looks like the wind's coming down from the
top. Yeah. Isn't it strange? It's kind of just, yeah, maybe just the way the figure has been posed like that. It, yeah, anyway. But looks like a nice, chunky, solid figure. And I just love that bit. It looks fantastic.
That's awesome.
Really, really does. So that's one that's getting ordered. Maybe one or two of them. The other one that was revealed was Apocalypse. Do you know much about Apocalypse? You a fan of this guy?
Not really.
No, neither am I. Is it everybody's like, oh, Apocalypse is awesome, but I guess because it's X-Men, but...
Yeah, look, and everyone's kind of mad for this whole Age of Apocalypse wave, which I really couldn't give a shit about. I'm really grateful it's coming out because A, it makes X-Men fans of that arc really happy. So that's a big tick. B, other people will love it. The figures are all great. And C, because I don't like it or want it, I don't have to worry about it. It's breathing space, and I need breathing space.
I know what you're talking about. I like it. I must admit, I do like it. I'm not a fan of the laughing head, the straightforward in the skull, and there's something about it I do like. I'll definitely pick up one and have a look at it and review it. But you're right. I think the entire Sugar Man bath wave, I just skipped. And I know a lot of people just were not interested in that wave at all. It just didn't hit. So, and to be fair, it didn't really reach a lot of countries or retail in any mass way. It was pretty much a fan channel kind of wave. It really didn't. I've not seen anybody talk about it or pick it up at retail, actually. So that's one pack shot of Apocalypse, Marvel's Apocalypse. There's the back shot of the card, if you want to, with his Shakespearean skull there. Not too bad. I don't know. I think I might go on maybe once I get one. There's another shot there. Looking not too shabby. The reason hands from something, and I can't remember what it was, but other than that, it feels like we've got nothing but Apocalypse the last couple of years, but there we go. And there's another final shot of him there.
You know, definitely looks better with the non-smiling face.
Yeah, that's what I think. I think it just looks, it suits it much better. Oh, for some reason, this is not, there we go. Yeah, it's just his grumpy Apocalypse face. Oh, these lips. I think it was one of the shorts. That's it. Happy Apocalypse. Pump and Freeze team. So the other one was the Retro Spidey Wave. Let's have a look at Spidey first of all, which I think we saw. Can you recall?
We've seen the
Mary Jane and the Peter Parker.
We saw Spidey at New York Toy Fair. But we haven't seen the package shots.
Well, there we go. On this glorious kind of late 80s, early 90s, I think it was, Spider-Man cartoon-based kind of comic-like packaging. It just looks fabulous, I think, on that card.
So this is, they're calling it Spidey 2.0. So the ab crunch isn't a ab crunch. I think it's the ball and socket thing.
You can see it there. Yeah.
For better posability. It still does have the pins, unfortunately, so it's not a pinless figure.
Yeah, but they're coloured correctly, anyway.
They are, but I think the inside arms are red.
Yeah, they are. They are. It's a shame.
The good thing is we've got two sets of hands.
Yep.
The bad thing is I want three sets of hands. Correct. Spidey has to come with three sets. He needs his Whippers, he needs his punching fists, and he needs his pizza holding kind of open hands.
Correct. Totally agree with you.
But loving that he's got his webs painted again.
Yeah, is that
so
right?
Sick of Spider-Man.
Oh, wow. So
I'm just sick of Spider-Man figures where it's kind of like, oh, look, you can kind of see them, but we don't want to put the black in there.
Yeah. He's got the butterflies going on in the joints. I really feel this is just barely noticeable as an extra swap out head. No?
Yeah, look, I think they could have gone more extreme with the eyes.
Yeah, I think so too. It just
it will work. It will work for toy photographers.
Yeah, I just don't see. It's really not a big deal in my mind, but there you go. What is nice, I thought about this was, let me just flip over here because, there was, I'm trying to just get the right card. Yep. There's this really nice little cartoony kind of way they've got in the background here, which I just love. I love that kind of instructional stuff because we don't get anything like that at all. I'm actually very surprised we didn't get that reused web fluidy kind of piece that's been in just about every 3.7 5-inch figure and quite a few 6-inch over the years. But it's nice back of the packaging. Love seeing photographs of the figures on the back of the pack. It's something I really miss, actually, like the old Collect-All 12, Collect-All 96 thing from Star Wars. But yeah, it looks really, really nice. The other one to notice, let's just go with this one here, is Daredevil. Brand new Daredevil, which we have not seen before, with Matt Murdock's swap-out head. Reused batons, which we've had before. Kind of interesting swap-out cuffs. I don't know.
Seems and what weird. Are the hands? I guess they're straight hands, are they?
They're fists, I guess. They're
not fists because he's already got fists. So.
I think they're just slightly open hands. Oh well. Kind of looks like a reused Spidey body. Because it's got the ab crunch. And then the Daredevil plate on the chest there. I don't remember this armor myself at all, but...
I don't remember it. I've seen it before, but I don't remember from what story or what place it fell.
I do love the old... the art looks great. The old style kind of fonts. Billy Club! It's, the kind of excitement about a small feature that they've got. It's kind of fun. The other pack shot was... There we go. Swap out head. I just love that stuff. And that's the back of the card for you. Although he is blind. Sorry, go ahead.
And I was just going to say, when you get back to your images, the outer shot, retail shot, is the very last image of the whole thing you'll see.
Yeah.
It's down next to Star Wars, yeah.
There you go. So it's the... look at that. The Billy Club's
club. Okay.
Okay, all right. Didn't know that. Okay, not bad. We also have Miss Mary Parker, or Gwen Stacy, actually, looking very good. Got a cool looking little outfit on and waistcoat. That hand, oh my God, they keep reusing that hand. And the swap out head there too. She's got a little blue binder, I think, from high school. Textbook accessory. Wow. Kids are going to be so excited for that. To be fair, this is, and I did clarify some information about this, this is very unlikely to be ordered in any quantity by mass retail. So Fan Channels is going to be the place to get these. One, to get it shipped in a proper fan condition. And two, to make sure you can actually get it. So don't rely upon, as we've seen from other reports recently, Walmarts and stuff. They suck. Gwen Stacy, there we go. Peter Parker, swap out head. Nothing else to really show you on that one. But the other look she can have is there. She looks completely different because it's a completely different head. And there's a blue book there, which I don't quite understand because I didn't see that. And, oh, there we go. There's the old accessories. Okay, so she's got what I first thought was a burrito, but it's a rolled up bit of paper and a little blue binder. Okay. And Midtown High School. Very nice. It's a good looking figure.
It is. Mine will be Gwen Stacy. It's such a Gwen thing. The addition of Mary Jane's good, but it's just weird as well.
Well, it does encourage people to buy two, I guess, in some ways. Another one is Green Goblin that we had not seen before. Glider and Pumpkin Bomb. And we get a Norman Osborn head with his trademark here. Really googly eyes on the eyes there, but I guess, googly eyes on the figure.
It's 100% new head.
Is it?
Wow. Yeah. The other one's realistic.
Yes.
And this one, that's the eyes that are really different, and it's just more cartoon sculpted.
Less paint. What a difference that little shiny effect had made onto the original figure that they released. But still a classic figure, really well done. You get the pumpkin bomb and the glider as well. Green Goblin looking very, very cool.
I love it.
Yeah, I agree. He looks really insane there with the eyes. But yeah, very calm looking Norman Osborn doesn't quite fit. I'd almost want to put that head on a spare suit body or something.
Yeah.
Just have a
apparently Marvel's got a few of them.
Yeah. Definitely made a few of them. Yeah, it looks good. It's a shame there's still no stand for that. They're like the Hobgoblin. That, I think the back of it just shows you, yep, the swap out head for Green Goblin. Figure's pretty, in fact, we hadn't seen Electro before, tell a lie. So there's a new Electro 2, Lightning Blast. And yeah, so you're thinking pretty much the same, you know, this is a bigger mold?
I think it's a bulkier mold than the other one is a Spider-Man mold, and that doesn't look like a Spider-Man body. It's definitely a new head, I think.
But
it doesn't look like Spider-Man's body. Spider-Man's body's leaner.
Yeah, you're right.
Definitely leaner. Definitely a new head as well.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's interesting. Who wears better than a yellow underwear? Seriously. The one thing I can't go over. The lightning hands, yep. And the little flash on the sides is new,
yep.
I guess, from previous Electros, if I recall. And
the other one.
Let's look. Hold on one second. Let me, what I'll do is stop sharing and like get a bigger screen that we can let you go.
So it's definitely a thinner body. It's definitely like Spider-Man's thin
body. Yeah, this new one's definitely thicker. And that was a Spidey body, wasn't it?
Yeah, this was a Spidey body.
Yep.
And that's the face.
Yeah, that's quite different. Yeah, it is.
Pretty it's sure different. It is. So the mask looks like it's still the same, but they've sculpted in eyes there that aren't really existent here, and the chin's a bit different and stuff. But you know, this one needed an update. This was always a bizarre Electro, which never came with alternate hands.
I really like that Electro. Actually, of all of them, I liked it with the swap out head. I preferred the less.
You like the
The
shaved head, yeah.
Just a tad more practical than the headgear he's got on, but there we go. Let us go back and share some more because there's still just a little bit more. So we had Electro, I think we covered
the just ball. Peter Parker now, isn't it? After just the
Peter Parker, I love that there with the
change your
hand. I love these little diagrams. I don't know what it is, it's kind of like the old instruction manuals you used to get. Yes, I think Peter Parker is the last one, which again we'd seen in some form before. I can't remember.
New York Toy Fair, we saw it on display.
Was it just the loose figure? Anyway,
it was the loose figure, and I think maybe we saw the packaging, but we didn't see the white retail image. It was the black, black glam shot.
So we're getting a little camera going on, which is nice, and quite a cool little body that he's got. Big Harry
Potter. Those glasses come off.
Thank God. I love the swap out head. That's a really nice touch. Camera is the exciting announcement on that one. And if we go to the other pictures, we'll just show the back of the card. Come on, there we go. And the swap out head again there. The Amazing Spider-Man. I feel like they should be advertised on Saturday morning cartoon time. That's kind of just really works well. Looks good. I really like that. Captures the kind of comic aspect really well. The Harry Potter glasses can die. They look awful. And they're really terrible. I guess, how do you do that? 6-inch scale is kind of hard. And that looks very much like some reused trousers from before. But yeah, solid enough. So what do you think overall? Are you
I'm all in it for Spidey set, and I haven't been in it for a full wave for a long time. So I'm there for it and not doing anything for a builder figure. Every figure on its own stands on its own, which is a good thing. Apocalypse is probably a pass for me, and War Machine is tempting, but let's see if I've got a job.
Yeah, COVID worries, I suppose, and everybody else is affected in the same way, I'm sure, out there. But all of these figures we've talked about at the time of this video are up for pre-sale. There's a link to Darkside Toys underneath. All of these are available from them, including the Star Wars figures. Go order them if you want fan quality figures. And just, I'm sure you saw, but there was a few 3.75-inch people getting all their Walmart
retro figures,
Boba Fett retro figures. I mean, they should have just chucked the box to a bunch of dogs to chew. And shocking.
I saw some really bad ones. And it doesn't help as well that, and for the, I guess, the aesthetic of it, that they're roughed up boxes or packaging.
Well, true.
And then they're actually roughed up to shit from Walmart.
Exactly. Giving you that retro feel. But there was also some other really bad packaging I saw the other day. The Slave One, the brand new Slave One, the Vintage Collection, which cost a fortune. And Entertainment Earth just shipped it in this flimsy little outer box rather than put it in a protective box. So a lot of people were losing it. So much for the mint condition. But anyway, buy from a good shop. Darkside, BBTS, both of those companies know what to do to ship a product. And I struggle to find any other firm really that does that. Star Action Figures does it. Robot Kingdom does it. Four of them. There you go. Four in the bloody globe that can pack things properly. And that's, for me, that's the kind of stuff for this, for the Spider-Man wave, that I want it to be in good nick. So that's what I'll buy. Got a couple of other things to share very quickly. Some new reveals. Matt and I talked about Power Rangers. They had a little reveal through the week. Or between the shows that we did. Some kind of really interesting reveals here, I thought. So there's a few bits and pieces here we'll just go through. I kind of love this, actually. I can't remember his name off the show. We'll find it in a second. But comes with a little teddy bear kind of droid thing he's got going on. But this is kind of interesting. Very Palpatine-esque hologram tube here for Power Rangers. And as we flick through, it goes quite, I mean, glam shot. Looks very good. Reality? Again, just be clear, look at the silver. It's all chromey, cool silver, light blue, very clear facial aspects. What happened there?
They put the photo reel on it.
Yeah, they didn't put the photo. The figure looks actually identical. It looks absolutely pretty close. The lighting's a bit off, but pretty good. So yeah, kind of interesting, another Power Rangers one. Very popular bunch of other figures. The putty dudes are coming in a multi-pack, so you can buy lots and lots of them. And frankly, I've now lost the plot with Power Rangers. I do not know what's going on, who's who. They all seem to just be the same slight tweaks on different colors. A green dude in the Power Rangers, if you know who it is, let us know. But more information will be coming on those guys kind of soon, and that was it. That was something actually we should mention as well, because one Mezco is 6-inch.
Yeah.
This Blade figure that got launched, this Mezco exclusive, it's pretty bad. Did you see this?
I heard about it. It's kind of missed it.
I know. I missed it too, and then I just saw it, and I was like, oh, this is really good, and it looks excellent, and it's, then I was like, oh my god, it's like 100 and something. Yeah, but my man, oh man, it's like really, really pretty slick. The fabric and the paint and the, it's quite the figure, but sorely tempted.
It did take longer than the other exclusives to sell. Things like the Batman sold in 10 minutes, whatever it was. Blade took a few hours, but it was still sold within the day.
Wow, completely sold out.
God, I think so, yeah.
Oh, well, there you go, I'm not getting one now. Mezco exclusive as well. The other thing, just very quickly to mention, was there's quite a couple of cool things over at Hasbro Pulse. They had some articles on their blog. One was called Behind the Build about toy photography, and a really interesting shot. Scott is his name. Takes you through the photo shoot where he made the Marvel Legends pack photos and some of the tips and tricks that he took. Some of them are genuinely quite simple effects that he uses really well. Well worth watching the video. He runs through, he's a very nice guy, explains it all. And you can see it's just a monitor background that, as Matt has shared many, many times on his page, people using monitors to capture just that kind of high quality. But just some lighting, some simple filters and stuff, and a lot of photoshopping. But it's a nice little video and well worth checking out. And there was another article on there, if you're a G.I. Joe fan, where the designer for one of the cool G.I. Joe t-shirts, I can't remember her name offhand, but she's an amazing artist and does a really, really good job of explaining some of the art. I think you and I both shared pictures of her or about her on the blog that they had.
Oh, is this the snake art? Snake
eyes? Yeah, the snake eyes art. Let me see if I can very quickly bring up her page again. Yeah, she was... I can't remember. They have such a weird site. I can't remember what's going on.
I'll tell you what it is, just a sec.
I followed her on... Where's our article? There we go.
Tracy Ching.
Thank you. Tracy Ching. Really good article, if I can find it on there. The website's really confusing. There's the t-shirt very quickly just to show you the art. So this is Tracy Ching's artwork here. And it's just gorgeous. A really, really nice t-shirt. Lots of nice details, which you can get on Pulse. So there you go. But yeah, it actually reminds me of the Three Wolves Howl at the Moon kind of phase that everybody went through. But there you go. So that's out there, and we're worth checking out. So because we've got a lot of reveals tonight, we're going to just go over some highlights. But if you were not aware, my God, where have you been for 60 shows? This man here that I do this show with curates a nice little slice of awesomeness on the internet, instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries, and as directors and other people have told you, this is one of the few pages they check on a daily basis. So, because there's great stuff on it, it's Toy Porn. Take us through anything that's new, and we'll give some proper, we should talk about this.
Yeah.
So,
it has to happen. Like, I mean, seeing what McFarlane's doing with that Batman figure, that what is it? It's 5 repacks of the black Batman to get the blue Batman as a chase figure, and that's the only way you can get it as a chase. A true chase and a genuine chase. This should be the same thing with Star Wars. They should put chase figures into cases or however you want to do it, but maybe fan channels get a grayscale figure, but the grayscale figures, which was said before, they just look so incredible. And again, somebody on the page here has asked me, and I'm not having a go at him, it's like, I don't get it. What's the point? It's like, you either get it or you don't. And that's not being a dick about it. It's like,
right. If
you see the grayscale figure and you go, man, I want that, then you get it. And if you look at it and go, why would you want a grayscale figure? It's not painted. It's like, well, you don't get it. And that's fine as well. Like, this is purely getting into, like, I don't know. I don't want to say the word fetish, but it's like, it's really, it delves down into a love of collecting or a love of the figure or the art of
the sculpt.
Loving
the
action figures. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think we covered this on many shows before, but it, as you can see in the photograph you shared, it just highlights the sculpt. It highlights every detail about it. That coloring is just awesome. It just really shows every bit of detail up. Now, that does a great job too, but there's just something about it I would just love. It's almost like a collection of prototype figures.
It is, and that's exactly what it is. It's like those who collect prototypes, this would be a not a prototype, but it's getting back to that basic thing. And if you think back to when Hasbro did that staff employee Chewbacca figure, the prototype figure, then the second mold, then the third one was the final one. This is that middle figure. This is the figure. We've gone through the colored prototype. Now we're looking at the grayscale figure, and then we get the painted version. And it's something for a different level of collectors.
Yeah. Kind
of thing. And niche. It's definitely not mass market. And it's something that I know a heap of people on my page would want a chase for.
Totally. I agree.
And not for every figure too, as we've said before.
Exactly. It's select. It'd have to be, otherwise you're replicating the entire lane. So
That Mace Windu looked incredible in grayscale, that first one we saw.
Yeah, right. There's loads of figures that really suit it well. So I've seen a lot of people posting the Rebel Hoth Trooper, just tons of them doing space swaps and all sorts of stuff. So look at that. How cool is that? Same old X. Nicely done. That really is rather cool. And that's 3.75 in the background to give it scale. That's nice.
It's awesome.
It is. Seeing that background just works really, really well. The 40th. Nice. What do you like with your black?
Look, as soon as 500 likes for a black square. For a
black screen. I love it. I love you. Yeah, with you. 40th Empire, but yeah, you're right. Get your page all looking good. Did you get your Luke Bespin yet? Did you?
Yes, I did.
What did you open them or?
Not yet. Not yet. It's not even from a not opening, because I've got the Hasbro ones and I got my ones, so I'm going to open one of them. Sure. I just want to go through and look at them and sort it out. But you know, with somebody who's got nothing to do at the moment, I've just got so much to do.
I know. But it's a great figure. It's one that I think a lot of people will really like. And as you can see there's a lot of shots of them. And they just look great in 6-inch. It's just a fantastic line. I'm just so glad when they made these vintage card backs. Looks superb. Good job, Homemade Galaxy, for that. And that's more of the Rebels. That's a great looking facial sculpt on that Hoth Trooper. It really is. Very strong indeed. It just looks so realistic. That's you. Tell us about this.
Look, this is an interview I did the other day with Brian Volk-Weiss, who made The Toys That Made Us, and he's got a new TV series coming out on May 29th called A Toy Store Near You. I guess the very simple thing of that is Amazon Prime, May 29th, will be the first look, and the first store is Billy's Toy Galaxy in Portland, Oregon. They're going to do 50 stores around the world, and these stories are about how toy stores that have all been forced to shut down because of COVID are surviving. It's about I guess the toy store, it's about the people who own the toy store, it's about the staff, it's about customers, kind of thing. And it's really good. I saw the first episode. I got to see in advance of the first episode, and it's good. It's interesting, and it's content that's made for us. So, you know, I'm all for supporting anything that puts toys on TV.
I agree. And it was a really good, I haven't watched it yet, but it was a really good TV series, The Toys That Made Us. Short, but you know, I guess it's a little hard to cut some of that material. But you three really nice shorts you've curated there, the blue, the orange, and the kind of gray. It looks very, very nice. Not with the same person, are they? No,
different people, but yeah, it all balanced out nicely. And we don't see much of L3.
We do not.
So it's always good to see a good shot of her.
Very, very nice one, but shooting the galaxy. Colors, and it's one thing, it's just that little Ghost Rider video I was talking about earlier, and just how the differences to colored lines and the filters can make can be quite important. But yeah, the usual smattering of awesomeness. Oh my God, we need play sets like this, man. Kuat Drive Yards. Hopefully Hasbro one day. Can't be that hard for them to do something like that. It's gotta
they be. Can 3.75. They can do it for 6-inch. Like, you know.
I don't know. Get it made. Get it made. And there's your stream there talking with Brian Volk. Volk Weiss. Is it Weiss?
Weiss.
Weiss. Weiss.
Weiss. Weiss. Weiss. Weiss.
Nice.
Like the ice cream bar.
And a nice moist scarf triple there for me. Thank you to you and a Visual Odyssey. That looks very nice indeed. Forgot about that one. And a few of that's a cracker. Once it loads from the Black Series, it's just really nice. It's very cool indeed.
Such a good figure.
It is. Is that a little bit of touch up on that, or is that?
I don't think so. I don't know.
Wow. It's pretty phenomenal.
Always comes back to the lighting.
It seems to go a little bit slow on my internet just now. Anyway, any other ones particularly you want to highlight? Or, I mean, they're all good, but. Well, that's
the vote happening.
Yeah, that's the vote. We should have talked about that, to be honest. Although nothing's changed really as yet,
and we don't get to see what's happening because it's all behind closed doors.
Yeah. Well, this was pretty consistent. This 10 from both of our fan polls. It was really pretty much not much difference, really, was it?
There was like what was it for me that didn't make it? I can't remember. Hondo didn't make it for you. Greedo and Jin weren't there for me. There was two others that were there. I can't remember what they were, but we'll see in a sec what they were. But yeah, look, I kind of tried to put out on the page the kind of idea, not just the go for the faces because take the opportunity and Cody's going to come anyway and all that other stuff.
Yep.
But people, you know.
I know.
I guess you can't get away from it. People who then take it like, stop trying to influence the vote and who do you think you are? At the end of the day, it's you've got an opinion, I've got an opinion. Your opinion's allowed on the page and so is mine. You know, and look, I reckon most of these will get made. The only one that I still think is, you know, the reason I want it voted for is because whether they will or won't do it is the Hut Slayer Slave Layer. But one thing I've been pushing for the last few weeks and will still stand back, and I found the articles, I found everything. Oh. Disney never said they were going to stop making it. Have never said that they would not make it. All they ended up saying was that, all it ever was a Marvel artist said he had heard there was an issue. Apparently there was a dad who complained or whatever. But it all came from this Screen Crush article, and Screen Crush's article says we contacted Lucasfilm and Disney for a comment and we've heard nothing. Like, it's never been out there. And Disney, I shared it on my stories. Disney shop online is selling pewter statues of Slave Leia for $300. It's like Minnie Mouse is a animated figure in the slave outfit. It's like,
It's the wording, I think, that seems obviously to be sensitive. And
yeah, so Hut Slayer now is what
Hut Slayer is the new thing to see. I know.
So look, that was a custom. That's not a repaint. That's a custom. But that was that's the head from Empire cut onto the Return of the Jedi one with the earrings added. But this isn't to say this is what it will look like. It's just to say there is a better figure there with photo reel technology.
So yeah, we'll find it soon. May 28th is when we find out about the vote, and we will tell you more. And you got to come to this page, instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries.
Yeah. Look, the one thing we should add is that's a face app on that Rex. Nice. If we keep going down, Jesse's photo will be here somewhere. We just passed one other one, but the Shadow Trooper came out in Australia.
What was that, sorry?
The Shadow Trooper, the somewhere down here will be Jesse's shots of.
This?
If you go back up, there's one from 6-inch AF.
That was a cracker too. Yeah, for some reason, the internet's just deciding to just grind to a halt. Maybe Mrs. Fly's on Netflix or something.
Anyway, the Shadow Stormtrooper came out in Australia.
And it's apparently just coming out in the States, I think, at the time of recording. I thought it was. I thought it was somebody mentioned. Or maybe it was just up for pre-order. That's what it was. But, yeah, you didn't pick one up, did you?
No.
Yeah, it was... kind of sucked. But there you go. Some people love it, some people don't. That's the thing about it. I was really thinking, this is terrible. And Jesse, who we both know, and a great dude, and he's like, I love it. And I'm like, okay, whatever. You know, everybody's different. Everybody's different picks and characters. And it's not a bad figure. It's just, yeah, some blue parts don't quite work for me. But his blue lighting and stuff there does make it look a whole lot better. Anything else you want to raise, or we want to quickly?
I think check out 6-inch Legends, check out 6-inch Show. Oh, we don't have to now. I'm just saying people can.
Sure. No, yeah, yeah. It's a good point just to end on. We're wrapping up a little bit quickly because this is a shorter show just to show you off these new figures, but we'll be back with another show and we'll spend a little bit more normal, usual time on toy photography once we see some other news. But definitely, yes, Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. Nice and simple to remember, as well as 6-inch Legends, Star Wars 1313, 1977, and Toy Tribe, and a few others that are in there too. So check them out. You can find everything from me on flyguy.net, and that's episode 60. We'll see you for 61. Cheers.
Bye.